So these are Ailanthus webworm moth caterpillars. These are pretty neat little caterpillars. This is one of the few species, a native species, of that's benefited from an invasive plant. This is actually used to be restricted to, these caterpillars used to be restricted to Florida. A couple of plants, I think they're called soapberries, where they used to live. But it turns out that that particular plant, the original host plant, has similar properties as the Ailanthus, the tree of heaven. And so they were able to, once this invasive plant spread all over, they were able to themselves be able to take advantage, and their ranges expanded dramatically. Now, even though they do feed on it, they certainly don't control it. This one's pretty extensively eaten away. But the honest truth is they really aren't going to be a biological control to actually control the number of Ailanthus trees, this nasty invasive, which supports very little other life and spreads like crazy. They live in these webs, which protects them. And then the moth itself, one of which was right here, and unfortunately didn't get the camera in time in order to be able to get a picture of it, are very, very colorful, which shows that, they're probably taking some of the liquids and chemicals from this plant itself and thus making themselves toxic. But these colorful little moths are able to survive that way. Oh, and by the way, this will soon be one of those little moths. I don't know if you can make it out, but inside there is a little cocoon that's going to change over eventually into one of those colorful little moths. Now, if I can look very carefully, I was hoping that the moth would be around somewhere close by so that we could take a good look at it. But it looks like, unfortunately, I scared them away, and I'm not able to do that. But again, this is Ailanthus webworm moths, one of the few species that has expanded its range due to an invasive species, the Ailanthus tree, which has now become a substitute host plant.